welcome to a very special episode of Beating All Odds. Coronavirus has swept the entire world into a whirlpool of economic crisis. This crisis is likely to have a major impact on advertising and marketing industry. In these times of difficulties and problems, we need our leaders more than ever. With me today is one such leader, a leader who is who's definitely a leader in a lot of sense, that he's the torchbearer of our society. We've been interviewing a lot of leaders who report to him in last few days. And the man who needs very little introduction with me today is Mr. CVL Srinivas, Country Manager, WPP India. So thank you very much for accepting to do this and coming on the show today.
Thanks, Naziya. Thanks for having me on e4m. Firstly, I hope you're doing well. I hope you, your family, and everybody at e4m is keeping safe and doing well.
Thank you very much, sir. So, sir, I want to start on a note of hope and optimism. Tell us, where do you see the light? Because from everywhere, we're getting bad news. The lockdown is expected to be extended. We are, the number of cases have increased. Where is hope?
Well, yeah, I mean, there's no denying the fact that right now we're going through very challenging times. You know, I grew up listening to stories about World War II from my granddad, who happened to be in London those days, with bombs falling all around him. And, you know, he used to tell us all those stories. And actually, this is probably a World War II kind of an event for our generation, maybe once in a lifetime, hopefully. And it's tough, it's challenging, it's everything is very different the minute you wake up in the morning, you know, the fact that you have to kind of work remotely and you're not sure how long it's going to last, you don't even know if there's going to be a cure, etc., etc. So yes, I mean, there's no denying the fact that it's challenging. But on the other hand, if you look for the positives, I think there are many. You know, we've seen so much positive change happen in the last 2-3 weeks. If you ask me, I don't think we've seen this kind of digital transformation in every aspect of our lives, personal, professional, ever that we've seen in the last 2 weeks. If you look at the way we, as organizations, industries, as people, just adapted to this, just shows that we're as a race, we're capable of a lot more. And as organizations as well. So it's also obviously teaching us to be a lot more patient, teaching us to be focused and stick to our goals. So I think we'll come out stronger. There is definitely a light at the end of the tunnel as and when we reach that, because all said and done, India is going to continue to remain the fastest growing major economy, although the numbers are obviously going to come down. It's also going to remain the fastest growing ad market, although again, like, the numbers are going to be scaled down pretty much. As things rebound, things are going to get exciting, and clients would need us a lot more than ever, according to me, given the challenges they're going to face. So for everyone on the agency side, exciting times ahead.
So, as the leader of WPP, and you have so many big agencies to handle. How are you keeping the morale of your agency heads and your entire lakhs of employees high at this point of time? What kind of initiatives have you taken? What kind of meetings are you holding with them? What is the message that you are giving to your employees?
I think what's worked well for us is a couple of things. I think firstly, we started planning for this very early on. The fact that we're a global company gave us some insight into how things panned out in China and later on in Europe and the US. And in fact, we had our global exco, the leadership team of WPP in Mumbai for almost a whole week, in the first week of March. When a lot of this is playing out, so literally the policy decisions and all of that were being taken in front of us. We were part of the whole thing, and therefore started planning quite early on. By the time the lockdown etc. started happening, we managed to move all our people to work remotely from home. We have 80 offices in India, over 15,000 people across all our companies, including our associates. So really talking of a massive setup in that sense. But frankly, even I was pleasantly surprised with the way in which it happened so smoothly. People adapted to new way of working pretty well. We had fantastic support from all our leadership teams across the different operating companies, the IT admin teams, the HR teams, and everybody practically across WPP. chipped in and ensured that this worked. So yeah, I think it was collective effort. So planning and all of us kind of working together made things happen, I would say, pretty smoothly.
So what are some of the things that you're doing? I mean, if you can give me some examples.
Sure. So first and foremost, you know, focusing a lot on our employees, our people, to try and see how do we ensure, first of all, they're safe, they're healthy, they are, you know, in good spirits, they're motivated to get back to the desk or their machines at home day after day. So quite a few initiatives on that front. We have, for example, created a learning and development program, which is kind of pan WPP, where we have got a lot of interesting sessions lined up. It's already kicked off with a fantastic response. We have sessions which are conducted by some of our own champions from within WPP. We also have sessions conducted by some of our partners. And we have quite a few fun sessions lined up as well. In fact, next week we're organizing a concert for all WPP employees, you know, obviously online, and it's going to be exciting. So there's that kind of stuff going on. Sorry?
A music concert.
Yes, it's a music concert. Music concert next week. We sent a teaser out today. We're going to reveal the details on Monday, and it's going to happen towards the end of next week. And there's lots of fun stuff which the teams are doing on their own, ranging from TGIF.
Are WPPs also participating in this, or is this just restricted?
Well, everyone's every market is carrying out their own activities. Some of our activities, some of our training programs, obviously are common and shared, as are theirs. And yeah, there's a lot of exchange happening actually with our global offices on this as we speak. So yeah, and so I spoke about training, I spoke about the fun stuff, and I think at the end of the day, it's all about, you know, keeping in touch on a daily basis, communicating with your teams, you know, actually over-indexing on communication. But at the same time, I also think this is a time when you shouldn't overburden your teams with too much work. I think it's important to kind of just stick to the basics and be focused, and just realize that everyone's going through stressful times, and just help out and reach out to one another. So I think as a family, as a unit, we've come together pretty well. In fact, just a couple of hours ago, we had Mark Reed, our global CEO, do an exclusive town hall for all the WPP employees across India. And Mark and I then did a Q&A with all our employees. So yeah, those are some of the things that we'll keep doing going forward as well.
After your own employees, clients are very, very important part of your ecosystem in your business, and they are, everyone is equally affected by this crisis. How are you dealing with your clients during these days?
Yeah, look, I mean, there's no denying the fact that, you know, they are like us. I mean, all of us are going through very, very tough times, and clients are obviously focused more on the here and now. Everyone's focused on, you know, how do we kind of get through the next 4 weeks, 8 weeks, 12 weeks. So for them, it's a question of, you know, supply chains getting restored, factories getting up and running once again, products reaching the shelves, and therefore the whole cycle then moving. So there have been, yeah, lots of conversations over the last couple of weeks I've had directly with clients as well as through my client teams. And one of the things we have tried to advise our clients is to say that if possible, try and ensure some amount of saliency for the brand, because study after study has shown that whenever things rebound, brands which have some amount of saliency come back a lot stronger. And then the other thing we're saying is, be careful with the kind of messaging that you run at this point in time. Need to be empathetic. Need to, you know, position yourself as a brand or service that's helpful, and so on. And of course, be very judicious with your spend, because at the end of the day, you need to conserve your resources for stronger and better days ahead. So how do you kind of have the most intelligent kind of a mix at this point in time? If you can't really have those big national campaigns, can you use digital media more innovatively, so on and so forth? But having said that, in fact, if you allow me, I just wanted to share some examples of work that has been done, yeah, for our clients, even in challenging times like these, by the various operating companies within WPP. And it just goes to show that, you know, despite all the challenges and pressures, you know, people are, you know, putting in some great work. And this is obviously,
it will be very inspiring for everyone who watches this.
And this is just a sample. I mean, this is not an exhaustive list. by any order. So Landor, for example, has pretty much overnight created a new packaging design for their client Jagatjit Industries when they got into the hand sanitizer line. So that was fantastic work, which was literally kind of done overnight. The glitch has turned out some very, very interesting campaigns in the last couple of weeks for clients like Diageo, Netflix, Lenovo, etc. Wunderman Thompson came up with the campaign, which is the Make Your Mask for the Times of India. This is from the Delhi office, and this obviously has got a lot of visibility and a lot of appreciation from folks all around. They've also done some very interesting work for HUL and UNICEF. GroupM did something very interesting. In fact, they had organized the Critics' Choice Award, which was meant to be a like an on-ground event with one of the industry bodies. And ultimately, obviously, the event couldn't happen. So they turned it into a virtual event, and it was streamed live a few days ago, and again received a lot of appreciation. It obviously showed thinking on feet and quickly adapting to the times that we're in. Autumn Grace campaign for Axis Bank, which we were talking about earlier, the first transfer campaign, I thought was a fantastic piece of work. 82.5's work for Himalaya, Luminous, and Sira, again, very, very interesting. Ogilvy has done interesting work again across all their offices. If you look at the Tata Sky and Asian Paints campaigns, which are on air, and Mondelez and other clients from Bombay, the work they've done for the Hindu, and Fortune Oil from Bangalore, UPI from Calcutta, and Mother Dairy campaign that they've done from the Delhi office. So across the board, again, some great work. And Genesis Burson, Cohn & Wolf, our PR agency, again, coming up with some very interesting ideas for clients like GSK, 3M, etc. over the last couple of weeks. So yeah, I mean, great work done across the board. So look, one is, on the one hand, we are advising clients to obviously try and see how best to manage resources, keep the brand salient, but we're also closely aware of the practical problems they're facing, and it's actually, it differs quite a bit by client, by sector. So I think just talking to them more often and being there as their trusted partner is what we're focusing on.
So you were telling me something that WPP is doing on CSR front as well.
Yeah.
In specific to coronavirus. So would you want to elaborate on that?
Yes, sure. So apart from obviously our people and our clients, being a large responsible organization in India, we're also very mindful of the fact that this is a time to kind of, keep our communities in mind and see what more can we do to the communities that we directly work with and beyond. So the WPP Foundation, through which we channelize all our CSR investments, has been doing phenomenal work over the last couple of years. It's run by Rama Iyer. In fact, she's won practically every award there is to win in the CSR circuit. And what we have done in the last couple of weeks, again, is through Rama and her team, we have lined up, options for our staff and for our operating companies to kind of contribute, for all the causes like the migrant issue that we're facing, the fact that they need support, the healthcare workers, and the fact that there's some contributions needed there as well. So we're contributing to these both as individuals and as organizations, and it's all being managed through our foundation. Apart from that, we're also doing pro bono work for some of the organizations as both as WPP and as individual operating companies. Anyone who needs our help in times like these, either to raise funds or whatever else, we're most willing and most happy to play our part.
That's really the need of the hour. So coming back to the economy and the crisis, I was going through a report that said China revenues went down by 17% in first few months of the virus. We are still in, 1.5 months into this thing, and the lockdown effectively came last 2-3 weeks ago. What is the sense you are getting for India right now? I know it is too early to talk about numbers, but where do you see us? Let's say it will be done by May or June. How much will it hamper the growth, and how much time it may take us to recover from this crisis?
Yeah, it's interesting you spoke about the China number, because those are kind of the numbers going around across businesses, that have and almost every business has got impacted there. And, you will see Europe and US also go towards those numbers as things catch on there. So I think that's what we could get to see in our market as well, in terms of, what would be the dips that we would see. It's very difficult, obviously, to put an estimate on what is it finally going to be, as well as how long is it going to take to recover. But the only thing I can say with a lot of certainty is, as and when things recover, India is going to be one of the probably continuing to be the fastest growing economy, as well as the fastest growing ad market, although the numbers are going to get scaled down quite a bit. So we'll have to kind of figure out. I guess it all depends on how long this thing prolongs in our country. Yeah.
So Mr. Reed was here just barely a month ago, and I remember attending his press conference where he said India is a standout market for WPP. Now, after this crisis, although the crisis has happened in many other markets, does this put more pressure on you? Because this is going to be a difficult year. So how do you think, if you can tell us some ways that are on your mind, that how would we be able to cope with this situation?
Yeah, look, I think this is one of those very rare occasions where I think the pressure is kind of equally distributed across every single person, or every market to that effect. And I'm sure it's the same across organizations. So, yes, I think we all will feel the pressure. I think all organizations will. But like I said, I think there are a couple of things to look up to as positives. I think one is the fact that India is all said and done a land of opportunity. Even now, we have massive headroom to grow. We have pretty strong fundamentals, actually, if you look at it. And the ad sector has been doing pretty well over the last few years, growing at decent double digits. We may not have a double digit growth, of course, in the coming year, but still there is some growth which is there. And look, more than anything else, I think we will all soon realize that the past benchmarks and the past rates of growth and the formulae and the models that we all got used to are not going to really be very useful going forward. I think we're all in a reset mode right now, and we'll have to figure out going forward what is a decent growth level for the industry as a whole and for individual organizations, and that to an extent, to a large extent, depends on the way the whole product or service gets transformed. I mean, let's talk of our own business, the advertising and the media business. I again personally think that there's a massive opportunity for agencies like ourselves to play an even more important role for our clients and their brands. I think there are newer opportunities that we could look at in terms of contributing to their strategy, to the way they kind of redesign their portfolio, the kind of brands that they need to kind of bet on in the post-COVID era, and even work around purpose and all of that will actually take on a new meaning. And I think there's a lot that we can do as an agency community. So the thing is to just stay positive. The minute you stay positive, you start seeing opportunities.
So even in the current scenario, when BARC is giving out numbers which are showing that the viewership has crossed all it's breaking its own records, particularly news viewership or digital, are there certain sectors or some marketers that you think should continue advertising even in these times?
Yeah, look, like I said earlier, on the one hand, it's important to keep brand salient and ensure that you don't completely vanish in times like these. On the other hand, one also needs to keep in mind some of the practical issues that clients may be facing, which, like in some cases, like no stock or whatever else, or extremely limited resources which they want to conserve when things come back. So I think it's a balancing act that one needs to do.
If I want to ask you the sectors.
Yeah.
There are
sectors like CPG, there are sectors like BFSI even now, education, and anything which is based on a technology or a digital platform, which are continuing to advertise, as you can see, and also some of the examples that I shared with you. So they will, some of them may have reduced their spends, but they are still pretty much there. Media, entertainment as well, one can count in that. But there are other sectors which have been challenged even before the COVID crisis, the auto sector, for example, or the telco sector, and to an extent the retail sector, and of course real estate as well. So I think those will take us maybe slightly longer time to kind of come out of it.
So there are a lot of young people who got into the business this year or picked up new jobs this year. So they look up to seniors like you for a piece of advice in these gloomy days when you know you've just started your career and something like this happens. What would you want to tell them?
I would say I'm an optimist at any point in time, and have been so throughout. At least try to be so. So I would look at all the positives. I would say that this is probably the best year to get into the industry, simply because this is the time industry really needs change agents. Industry needs people with a fresh perspective. Industry needs people who can challenge the status quo, challenge all the old mental models, many of which we need to throw out of the window. So I think, you know, it's that chance to stand up and be counted. If anything, I think people who really come and make a mark can really fast track their progress within the organization, having joined in this year. So yeah, just keep it up and just keep going on. Yeah.
Sir, there's a lot of talk about this crisis having a very major impact on print. The distribution was affected. Outdoor is completely locked because, you know, people are not stepping out, so nobody is spending on outdoor. In cinema is again another sector of advertising which has been affected very badly. So how much time will it take for these sectors to recover, or what should they do right now? I mean, as an expert, what would you suggest to them?
Well, I think this is the best time to go back almost to the drawing board and say that how do I reshape my business or my platform for the post-COVID era? And we've seen shades of that happening already, right? We've looked at the whole print industry, and hats off to them. They've all been extremely agile and come up with digital PDF, easy to read versions on the mobile. And today, in fact, I spend a lot of time in the morning reading the PDF versions of several newspapers, including what my good friend sends from Bombay, midday, and others, which otherwise I would not have read in Gurgaon. So I think that's a great example of the medium adapting to the changing times, and I'm sure we're bound to see a lot more such innovation going forward. And look, we said this earlier, I think this is something which ultimately we will come out of, and when we go back to building brands and getting brands back on air, etc., I'm sure all these media will go back to seeing growth, whether it's print, whether it's outdoor, radio, whatever else. Yeah.
So before we end, what is that one final thought you want the industry, you want to leave the industry? I mean, something that you would want to tell the industry?
Well, it would be to seize the moment. I think we should say that this is a once in a lifetime opportunity for us, which has come. And, you know, whether it's about our own personal transformation, whether it's the organizational transformation, whether it's coming up with new ideas, with innovation, or whatever else, thanks to what we have right now, let's make the most of it and come out with something which is stronger, something which is more reliable, something which is more in tune with the times, whether it's a product, service, or whatever else. So it's a great opportunity to unlearn a lot of stuff which is going to be useless going forward, and pick up all the new things. Yeah. So seize the moment.
And are you also following your hobby? You're a tabla player, right?
Yes, I'm trying to. I'm trying to. Yes, I'm trying to do that. I'm trying to also be a bit more regular with my yoga. I also spend a bit of time in the kitchen. I like cooking every now and then, although my repertoire is fairly limited. But it's quite a few things to keep me busy apart from work, of course.
Sir, thank you so much for joining us. This interview will inspire many in this industry. And stay at home and stay safe.
Thank you. Same to you. Wish you all the best. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Thanks.